Hello everyone and welcome to the Inconel TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you a TIG root on an Inconel 625 filler wire. As you can see here from this example, there's bad coverage, lots of mistakes and stuff that's going on with a welding Inconel. Anything can go wrong, especially if you got a bad coverage, bad setup, prep, wrong the broad inclination, tungsten inclination and so on. So I'm gonna show you in this video how I'm doing it. Before that, I'm just gonna cut those two coupons and rebevel them. Okay, so for the gap, I got 316 gap all the way around. It's not perfect, but it's in just three bridge tacks to hold it in place. One of the most important thing on Inconel and stainless, pretty much on any pipe, is clean. Gotta be clean, especially inside for the root, especially if you're doing like I said, any alloy, gotta be clean as you're purging. So you don't wanna have any contamination inside. You wanna have nice clean puddle, and to accomplish nice clean puddle, everything gotta be pretty much perfect. There's lots of little things that makes your life harder or easier, depends. Okay, before that, please subscribe, click that bell icon so you stay up to date with all the content that's coming out. Okay, now it's a 5G, as I said, 316 gap. I try to maintain 316 gap all the way around. I'm gonna start from the bottom. From the bottom up on both sides. Okay, so diffuser, just gonna place it. Yeah, I like to use a diffuser on an argon hose, just the way how it disperses the argon. It's really good, covers pretty much everything, especially on a 6-inch. As I said, Inconel 625 ER nickel chrome moly 3 for the machine, big blue, this beauty. And set up on a TIG lift arc. I set up machine on the 200 amps with my remote time around 45, 50, it all depends. As I said, I'm gonna start on the bottom one side, 6 all the way up to 3 o'clock, and the same on the other side. Depends from the angle, from inclination. You can fit on the side like 30 degree, or you can go above that tack and like a little back feed. It all depends what's easier, what's better for you. Introduce you to TIG sleeve. This is TIG rod storage tube, a special design for TIG welders. Every unit is handcrafted, features an O-ring seal to protect your TIG rods from moisture, dust and any damage. 37 inches in length, so it's gonna fit full-size TIG rods, weighing just 2.6 pounds with a 10-pound rod capacity. Strap it over your back to stay mobile and hands-free while you're climbing, crawling. Comes in 5 different colors and you can check it out on tigsleeve.com. As I said, there's a couple different ways that you can do it. I'm just gonna walk the cup on this one and have like 60-70 degree angle on my rod. Or you can freehand it with 25-30 degree. You gotta be careful with your inclination, especially the way how you're opening that because you're purging. But for this one, it's a little bit different than stainless. So with stainless, it's a little bit like, even with a purging, with the argon flow settings and your amperage. The way how I'm purging this Inconel is pretty much closed. There's no, the only vent is up on the top. On my flow meter, as you can see here, it's more than 70, or you can max it out. I would even recommend to max it out all the way. Tungsten 1/8 and cup size 8. And I'm just gonna walk the cup on the root. You can freehand, depends what's easier, what you're most comfortable with. I try a little bit of different techniques on Inconel, and I find that walking the cup on the root is the best for me. I want to start initial arc, try to bridge that puddle, and just focus on your tip of your filler rod. You want to be pretty much connected all the time with your puddle. Keep it just slightly above that edge inside, as you want to do some buildup on your root. You don't want to have it flash, especially for the, as I said, always sag back on your hat pass. I try to keep it inside, slightly above that edge inside the root. And you can leave it, like when I was purging, you can leave it maybe 5 minutes to make sure the whole air is purged out. So this is most important thing, guys, when you're welding Inconel. Clean your pipe, that's number one, 100%. Gotta be really clean, go at least inch and a half from edge on both sides of the weld, and really nice good prep. Nice and clean all your TIG parts on your TIG torch and sharp tungsten. And absolutely your argon coverage. That's gotta be 100% good.
Okay, so this bottom up, I go from 6 o'clock to 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock. This is where I got one tack. I'm gonna remove that later. Now I'm gonna do the other side. I don't use any grinder here on a stop start on this part. I will do use it later when I cut those tacks out. As I said, as you can see here, it's pretty much like a back feed. That's why we really need a good purge, a strong purge, because Inconel is that puddle is behaving a little bit different. So if you got any bad purge, or if it's not clean, they call it like wet puddle, or it's like a little oily, it's really hard to manipulate. There's lots of like oxidizers going on inside. It's getting really hard to, as I said, to manipulate that puddle, especially if your pipe is not really clean. You're gonna really have a hard time to control that puddle. And once it's getting liquid, when it's getting really hot, perfect temperature. That's the other thing you gotta dial in with your settings, with your with pretty much with everything, with the technique that you like the most. You want a freehand or you want to work the cup. There's a couple guys here on the site, we were doing some testing and they did a freehand. It looks really nice. The most important thing is just your rod inclination and your gas coverage. So you gotta be really covered, no any blow indications inside of oxidation. So that's a good sign. So it's really clean and that's how it should be. Okay, so for this part, on the top section, once I remove that tack, I'm just gonna probably, the top section, I'm just gonna dab it right in the middle and or side to side. As I said, I'm gonna clean the stop starts, grind a little bit to just remove it. But once you strike initial start on your tie-in, if you didn't grind it out, it's gonna be a little bit oily on the top of your puddle. Once you gotta get off good heat, and as I said, you got a really good control over your puddle. You just gotta have that trowel speed and a feeding hand. You don't want to pause too much, as you can have internal undercuts. And for the top part, same thing. I'm just gonna feather out both sides, and I'm gonna tie in on a 12 o'clock. As I still didn't reduce any purge, as purge is pretty much maxed out, so I'm just gonna open a little hole here, just so it doesn't push that puddle, as gravity works here on the top section. Now I'm just gonna dab right in the middle or side to side, depends from the gap. Gap already shrank a lot, as you can see here. As I said, initially it was 316. And now it's like tight 532, even less on the top. And before tying, I'm just gonna pause here, side to side, add rod as needed on the both edges. Before I make that tie-in, I'm gonna pause here, dab it a couple more times. Just gotta create that feeling that you know how much is enough. And then just go over it like a half inch, and that's where you finish on the side of the wall. Okay, now the moment of truth, I'm just gonna cut it open and see how the root looks like. Okay, pretty much that's a good root all the way around. Just got some debris from grinding inside. It's nice and clean. Those blue sections where you see that, that's from tacking. I got an oxidizing side, and this is a little bit different angle. It's a nice good ring all the way around, a good argon coverage, pretty much consistent steps, consistent weld, which is good. If you got any issue, I hope this helps a lot. And as I said, if you guys like it, like, subscribe, share, and see you in the next one. Before that, if you already didn't, make sure to subscribe, click the bell icon so you got all notification, all my content, and see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.